Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 44th video class of DIP, we will study the differences between lossless compression and lossy compression in digital image processing. In our 35th video class of DIP, namely image compression fundamentals in digital image processing, we saw that data compression may be of two types, lossless compression and lossy compression. We are studying different lossless image compression techniques from last few video lectures. And now, before studying lossy compression, let us understand the differences between the lossy image compression and the lossless image compression, which is a very important question that can be asked in the exams. So here there are two images. One image is in the PNG file format, which is a lossless compression method, and the other image is in the JPEG file format, which is a lossy compression method. So comparing the two images, visually at very first sight, we do not see any major difference between the two images. But if you look closely and when you zoom out, you will find that this display board is very clear for this lossless compression technique as compared to this lossy compression JPEG file. As well as the same thing is applicable to this display board as well as this display board. And also you can compare the clarity of the skin between this image, and you can see that here the sharpness is much better as compared to the lossy compression image. So as the name suggests, for lossless compression there will be no loss of information, and for lossy compression there will be certain loss of information. So let us start. This column shows different comparison parameters for lossless compression and lossy compression. Starting with the definition, the technique in which no data loss occurs and output image is same as the input image is called the lossless image compression. That means the image will be compressed while transmission, but at the receiving end, the complete image can be recovered successfully. Whereas the technique in which there is data loss and the output image is not the same either in size or visually as the input image is called the lossy image compression. Next, for removal, lossless compression removes only the redundant information, that is, it removes the coding redundancy and the interpixel redundancy, while the lossy compression removes visually irrelevant information or psychovisual redundancy also. For lossless compression, there is no information loss, while for lossy compression, there is always a loss of information to certain extent. The other name of this lossless compression is reversible compression. Why? Because it can be reversed, while the other name for lossy compression is irreversible compression, because it cannot be reverse, and we will be quantizing certain values, and we know that quantization is irreversible. The compression ratio for lossless compression is low. From last few video classes, we find that the compression ratio is around 1.7, 1.9 or so, right? Whereas the compression ratio for lossy compression can be very, very high. It can be higher, like 5 to 8 times or even more. The algorithms or techniques that are used for lossless compression are bitplane coding, run length coding, Huffman coding, LZW coding, arithmetic coding, etc., which we have learned in the previous video classes. So the examples of lossy compression algorithms are transform coding, DCT, that is discrete cosine transform, discrete wavelet transform, etc. So this DCT is used for JPEG compression. The root mean square error, ERMS, between the original image and the reconstructed image is always zero for lossless compression, because there is no error in reproduction of the original image. Whereas here ERMS will never be equal to zero, and there will be certain error that will be always introduced. The advantages of lossless compression is it retains the file quality in smaller size, so file quality will not be lost. Whereas the advantages of lossy compression is it gives significantly reduced file size. Much, much larger compression is achieved. It is supported by many tools and softwares, and here we can choose preferred degree of compression also. While the drawbacks of lossless compression is that the file size is much large as compared to the lossy compression, and hence the data holding capacity is very less as compared to lossy compression. For lossy compression, we can incorporate many images in smaller memory size. The drawback of lossy compression is the quality of file is low and the file is degraded, and original file cannot be recovered with decompression due to quantization. The applications of this lossless compression includes text files, medical images, space images, etc. All the places where we do not want any loss of information is the application of lossless compression, whereas lossy compression is used, for example, images, speech and videos. The examples for lossless compression includes PNG, TIFF, BMP file format, etc. Whereas the examples of lossy compression includes JPEG, MPEG, MP3, etc. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a good knowledge from this video lecture. Thank you very much.